First year English, lecture number 54, topic The Hollow Man, poem number 10. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. First year class, how are your students? I hope you all fine. And I say welcome to all of you in my class. And beta, today inshallah, we shall study about a very great poet of 20th century. And his name is Thomas Stearns Eliot or T.S. Eliot. Beta, he was a great poet, essayist, publisher, playwright, literary critic and editor as well. So, he was born on 26 September 1888 and he died on 4th January 1965. Beta, he got a prominent place among the writers of his age and he did very hard work, beta, and his literary work, it had a great, you can say, acknowledgement by the people and by the critics as well. So, beta, he, for his notable works, he got Nobel Prize in Literature. Okay? So, beta, when he started writing poem in 1905 up to 1965. It means his literary span or his you can say creative span, it has 60 years, and beta, it is the longest period for any writer to work and to leave a mark in the history of the English literature. So beta, we shall start his poem The Hollow Man, and as you can see from the title is quite obvious that what is the poet talking about. The Hollow Man, hollow mean empty, nothing in your inwards. So beta, he, the 20th century man, according to T.S. Eliot, the 20th century man is a hollow man. Okay? So, beta, first of all, let's start stanza number one. We are the hollow man, we are the stuffed man, leaning together, headpiece filled with straw, alas. Our dried voices, when we whisper together, are quiet and meaningless, as wind in our dry grass or rat's feet over broken glass in our dry cellar. This is stanza number one. Beta, first of all, I will tell you that as in every, while explaining every poem, beta, I tell you that you have to write the reference and the context. Beta, in today's lecture, I couldn't write, you can say, context, but I will tell you verbally. Okay, beta? So what will be its context and reference? That first of all, what will you write as a reference? Okay, these lines have been taken from the poem The Hollow Man by T.S. Eliot. So beta, this is the reference of the poem, and what will be the context? That the poem laments the spiritual barrenness, materialistic attitude, moral degradation and aimlessness of modern man. ठीक है बेटा, समझ आई बात की कि जो पोइम है, ये जो पोइट है, लैमेंट्स, लैमेंट्स होता है मातम करना, अफसोस करना. सो द पोइट पोइम लैमेंट्स अपॉन द स्पिरिचुअल बैरननेस. स्पिरिचुअली वी आर बैरन, देयर इज नथिंग इनसाइड आवर सेल्फ. सो मटेरियलिस्टिक एटीट्यूड, मॉरल डिग्रेडेशन एंड एमलेसनेस ऑफ मॉडर्न मैन. इट डिपिक्ट्स दैट मॉडर्न मैन इज इनकैपेबल ऑफ टेकिंग राइट डिसीजंस फॉर द गुड ऑफ mankind. But you can add more sentences, one or two more in the context in order to elaborate it more. So it's up to you. So beta, let's start explaining the stanza number one. So what is the poet here is saying? That we are the hollow men, we are the stuffed men. Okay, stuffed kya hota hai beta? Anything that is filled with something. Theek hai na? So we are stuffed men, we are the hollow men. Hollow men, that we are empty from our inner side. It means we have our outer beauty, and from the outer side we are looking quite good, but from inside we are stuffed, and we are stuffed with straw, alas. Leaning together, headpiece filled with straw, it means that in our head, in our mind, there is nothing. ठीक है ना, कि इफ वी आर नथिंग इनसाइड, इट्स मीन दैट वी हैव बिकम स्पिरिचुअली डेड. वी आर स्टफ्ड विद अननेचुरल एंड बियर्स नो रियलिटी एट ऑल. समझाइए बेटा. आवर ड्राई वर्सेज व्हेन वी विस्पर टुगेदर आर क्वाइट एंड मीनिंगलेस एज वी आवर ड्राई ग्रास. ही सेज दैट कि ऑल्दो वी स्पीक बट आवर स्पीच इज एज मीनिंगलेस एज वीन इन ड्राई ग्रास. ठीक है ना. वी विस्पर टुगेदर आर क्वाइट एंड मीनिंगलेस मीन टू से ऑल्दो वी टॉक बट आवर स्पीच आवर टॉकिंग they are as meaningless as wind in dry grass, as wind in our dry grass, as wind in dry grass or rat's feet over broken glass. So it means that the modern man, he has become a pathetic picture with paralyzed force. Nothing extraordinary, nothing substantial, nothing remarkable thing can be expected from him as he is hollow man from within and his soul has gone dead. So as we say that, the poet says that we are filled with straw. So it means he has turned into a living corpse. Corpse, you know, that in your mind you have nothing in your mind. Your mind is empty and it is filled with straw. It means that we have no ability to think, to take some action, and we have spiritual barrenness as well. So the poet says that the modern man or the man of 20th century is unable to take any decision, is unable to do anything extraordinary because we are the hollow man. We have nothing in our inside. Dil ke andar kuch hoga to beta wo bahir aayega na. So it means we have lost activities, we have lost actions, and spiritually we are dead. So beta, very beautifully, T.S. Eliot is a master of poetry. So we can say that he very beautifully, beta, highlights the barrenness, the inactivity, and you can say we can say that jo uska beta hai na ke modern man is not working well. ठीक है. He is not active. He is not doing anything that will take him to some other world. So he is not doing anything extraordinary. This is the point that the poet wants to make us, that he urges the modern man to do action and a positive attitude. And modern man should have positive attitude to cope with the challenges he faces today. So he wants to say that modern man, he is unable to face the challenges of today because he has nothing inside him. He is devoid of action, he is devoid of thinking, he is devoid of spirituality. So what is left inside him? Just straw, just barrenness. So as we whisper together are quiet and meaningless as wind over dry grasses. जब बेटा हवा चलती है ड्राई ग्रास में, so it makes just noise and the grass, it doesn't do anything, it cannot do anything. So in the same way we whisper as a beta, जो एक dry grass है, it is no any more useful ना for anything. जैसे एक चारे के लिए इस्तेमाल होती है या एनिमल्स पर इस्तेमाल होती है, होती तो है but it is not as much useful as the green grass. So beta, that's why beta, he is comparing our voices with dry grass and the rat's feet over broken glass, because he wants to show that we are living a meaningless life. There is no aim in front of us. We are dividing from the main objective of our life, that is action. So modern man, he is just talking, and the talking are meaningless. There is no aim, there is nothing. They cannot do any initiative. So that's why he laments over the inactiveness of modern man, and he writes this poem in order to make us aware and in order to highlight the problem of the modern day, that is modern man jo hai, he is a hollow man. He is just living his life, but he is just a living corpse. He is just a living corpse because we inside it, from our inside, we don't have any emotions. We don't feel anybody's pain. So that's why we are hollow, na? Because in our heart, we have nothing for others. we have no feel, we have no feelings for other people. So beta, the poet wants to make us active person and spiritually alive. That's why I say that we are spiritually dead. So beta, I hope you have well understood the poem, and inshallah in the next lecture I shall explain its second stanza. And beta, I hope that you have well understood, and if you feel any difficulty, if any point is not clear to you, you can ask me, and inshallah I will try to remove your problem with the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So beta, I said Allah Hafiz for this lecture today.